Good morning for those of you in Europe and good afternoon for those in China. This is Romina Di Martino working at the China Italy Chamber of Commerce, one of the implementing partners of the EU SME Center. Today's topic is Artificial Intelligence China 2030. The EU SME Center is a project implemented with the financial support of the European Union, assisting SMEs to do business in China by providing a comprehensive range of hands-on information, advices, trainings, and other supporting services. The center is implemented by a consortium of six partners, and CICC is one of the partners who organized the webinar today. The China Italy Chamber of Commerce, CICC, is a business organization that aims to boost the internationalization and settlement of Italian business and to promote the Made in Italy in the PRC. The CICC offers informative training and business networking opportunities to the companies, as well as a voicing platform for them to share topics of common interest. Moreover, to companies interested in strengthening their business in China, the CICC offers consultancy, assistance, and marketing services. The CICC is one of the six implementing partners of the EU SME Center. Let me introduce the speaker of today, Mr. Gianluca Giorgi, General Manager at LAC Hong Kong LTD. Gianluca has got 14 years working experience in China market. He is a professional expert in factory automated plants and plant simulation to set up industry 4.0 factories. He has got a specialization on IBM operating system software engineer in the automation field. He has worked at General Electric Fanuc in automation division as advanced system integrator and later moved to digital automation division. He also got a degree in software engineering from Allen Bradley, Siemens, Telemecanique, US Data, Oracle and National Instruments. And one of his main expertise is development deep machine learning technology. In 2002, Gianluca has been managed the R&D team in order to develop the first woodworking sanding machine using fuzzy logistic agents. The project has been supported and promoted by European Union FP7. Gianluca has been also director of several projects for big Italian groups, such as Fiat Group, Magneti Marelli, Lombardini and Gyms, Ariston, Guzzini, Viet, etc., dealing with fully automatic production lines, automatic warehouse system, and fully robotized production lines. Now I would like to hand over to Gianluca.
Hello to everybody, this is Gianluca Giorgi, and I'd like to give my thanks to the EU-SME Center, give us the possibility to record this webinar, for extend the China policy on artificial intelligence also to European companies. With this webinar, I will give you a clear idea in which way the China's AI world evolving and in which are the targets. In this first introduction, I'm going to highlight a bit the human dream and in which way the human dreams will become reality. All of you know that the idea of an animate object coming to life as intelligent being has been around for millennia. The ancient Greek and myth about robots and Chinese and Egyptian engineer build automation. We know in 1,000 years ago, all in the war the army likes to copy the human body for scare the enemy and use some kind of manual automation or manual mechanism for support the war. But this kind of a copy of a human body become more deep and more intelligent in 1956 when they start to think, to copy the human brain way, a way of think, wave of of elaborate and the information. So at the beginning of the modern AI can be traced back the classical philosopher attempt to describe human thinking as a symbolic system. But the field of AI wasn't formally founded in 1956, the name gave to them to this technology at the Dartmouth College Conference in Hanover, New Hampshire, where the term artificial intelligence was coined. But achieving artificial intelligence was not so simple. After several reports criticized the progress of AI, so they cannot see some develop fast some result easy way, the government funding and the interest in this field dropped off. So from 1974 to 1980 become one cold period for AI, we can call AI winter. The field later reviewed in 1980 when the British government start to fund it again, in part completed with effort by the Japanese. And in 1980 we started to have some Japanese product with the AI inside, like autofocus camera or some robots for walk, for drive, and any kind of terrain. And then we had another period where this technology dropped off, where the fund missing, and so the technology didn't go on. The field experienced another major winter from 1987 to 1993, coincided with the collapse of the market of some early general purpose computer, so reduced the government funding. So we can see each time when the fund for the research will drop down, the AI technology get a winter period, a cold period. But McKinsey Global Institute estimated in its famous paper, Big Data, the next frontier for innovation, competition, and productivity, that by 2009, nearly all sectors in the USA economy had at least an average of 200 terabytes of stored data. By 2016, the market of AI-related product, hardware and software reached more than $8 billion. And the New York Times reported that interest in AI has reached a frenzy. So we can even know more in which way this technology coming hot when the government fund support the research to develop new algorithmics, new library, new function for that. And now we will see there are big companies also quite interested to the data can come out from the server using AI technology. And this why? Because the new the big data are really big data inside our server. And this data is kind of gold in commercial way, in statistics way. So, but the engineer are not enough the engineer in the world for extract this data. So the AI, the artificial intelligence was the new system and the new technology for support this data come out and be useful in the many kind of business. Now, today we are going to explore and explain the below topics. The first one is we will see which are the Chinese government policy and their targets. Which is the Chinese market status of the artificial intelligence project? We will go in to see and analyze some of artificial intelligence cases in China. And also, quite important topic, the possibility for the European small medium companies can have in AI industry in China. And at the end, the conclusions of this webinar will be quite clear of will clear a lot about the status and all of the strategy in China happen in this period. So go on with the first topic.
Now we are going to see the China government policies and we can go to understand more. Starting now with the China's policies, government China policies. What you can see here is one page belong to the China government where there are the guidelines of an artificial intelligence development. The China government, they are quite clear in the strategy and what they can, the target they want to get. And they are really focalized in this kind of a technology. And you can see how much money they decide to invest in this kind of technology till 2030. They give this 2030 as a target, year target. But this 2030 is only, we can say, the period of born of this technology, because now, with you can see here they invest 1 trillion yen, means 147 billion US dollar on this kind of technology system. This one for push for start this kind of business and project in China. They want to develop the complicated developing. In AI, complicating the systematic project, they want to promote the country technology, economy, social fair, maintain national security, and contribute to the world. What I like there in the center of this article is should be made the basic theory of the AI, such as big data intelligence, multimedia aware computing, human machine hybrid intelligence, swarm intelligence, automatic decision making. Advanced theories which can potentially transform the AI should also be looked at, including advanced machine learning, brain-like computing, and quantum intelligent computing. All of us know this kind of technology. For some part, they still quite innovative. They still our research. As before I said, you know, before we don't have so much fund for develop this kind of technology. So also the research, the innovative product is only developed for some field. Now the China want to promote this kind of technology, a funding for use of this technology in a transversal way to everybody in the business. But what missing, like all the new technology, they cannot born suddenly. Even the Chinese engineer, they already many studied this kind of technology. But you know, without a practical case, without the experience of the European people, American people, in Europe, we already studied many years ago. We studied we developed many projects. But those project guys still inside our university. So, or in some sample project for some research funded before by European government, now is the time for use this knowledge, use this experiment we done before in the real market. Because now, first of all, the China government and then all the big company in China, they going to invest in this technology. And I will explain you why, even it's already quite clear in the next slides. So we can focalize in the some key concept. China as AI Global Innovation Center by 2030. What means? Means they want to reach this goal. The China government is very persevering and forcing and obtain a result when the directive concerns national targets. So means this one is a national target. And in China, all the technology center, all the companies follow in a strictly way the China government directive and governance for these things. China is a wide country. There are 1,000 innovation centers. So, and the Research and Development Center and private group, and all of them will abide by Beijing policies. The necessity to innovate the basic theory of AI. This one we can understand that the 1,000 innovation centers need experts for support them. All of us know that 1,000 students, even they are already creative in new technology, they need some expert to support them, to let the project become become real and useful in the market. Most of the factories still employ only workers to make the production here in China, and many countries in Southeast Asia, the labor cost is cheaper than China. So China needed to develop the technology. China wanted to be at the same time, I mean, the same level and at the same time, a great power in terms of quality and efficiency. It does not want to recognize just for a low cost of labor. The only way to be more competitive in the market in the long term is investing in technology. So the AI, the robotics, the Industry 4.0, all of this technology, China will invest and will follow carefully. So by reading these sentences, we already have a clear idea about what China is looking for. And by reading it carefully, we note that that nothing is missing from what AI normally involves. It means that China must be 100% compliant with the AI application philosophy. The field China wanted to reach with AI are huge. Each word written in this sentence corresponded to one of field of big enough to keep busy thousands of scientists and engineers in Europe and all the world. Now the big AI players are starting the game. You know, all of us starting in working in this field, we have the possibility to show our power to test and in the market and test with the fund for support the this technology in China, and China supporting us. Now all the Chinese IT scientists and this center are starting the competition to be the most excellent in eyes of the country. And so now is the time for who in the world work in this field to come to support them in this big race. What is watching, who is watching this webinar, sure is one field involved in, because you are European, you know in Europe the last 20 years, we didn't have enough fund for this technology. Now the big data, and China has many, will and have many fund about that, can support us to set up new technology, set up new innovative center for develop. Who, like me, started the co-engineering automation data exchange projects 30 years ago with international companies. Don't you have the feeling that we start a new game, a new advanced project in this market? You think when in 1990 we started the internet business, and that time the world started to be professional inside that, and then we start to develop application inside this field. And the new technology available today must be integrated with using the AI algorithms, because China's huge data, a big data is in China is quite huge. Every day Chinese people load in the cloud system terabyte and terabyte of data in sentences, photo, movie, everything. How many human engineers are needed for analyze this data? Only AI can do that, we know. So you can imagine how many data we have in Europe for how many engineers we have for analyze, and according to the population in Europe, you can think in China the same. And the Chinese, most of them, they have more than one mobile phone each, and they can load each day tera and terabyte of data to be analyzed, because this data, all of us know, will be the future gold. So China needs support to extract this gold from its mine. The new generation must be trained and become the new brain inside this field. The new generation must be enabled to support and develop the new idea. Now, we go together to have a look about the China's market status, even some of you already know. The China's market has a big platform, e-commerce channel platform. The most big one, like Taobao, Amazon, JD, Alibaba. This kind of platform, each day, billion of consumer for China, but also outside China, they load data, request of a product, request of information about the product. So all this kind of data become the big data, because all the information about the product, about personal information, about the product you're looking for, the detail and the characteristics of the product you're looking for, all each day, all of us load the data in this kind of a big data. So at the end, we are creating the mines of the data to be analyzed. I extract this page from Cisco system, where all of you can have the clear idea what one smartphone, how many data can load daily inside the cloud, inside can fill these mines. All of you knows that 1 petabyte is 1 million gigabyte. So here the number are in petabyte, because the gigabyte are no more one scale useful for this data, because we are still talking about a petabyte of data to analyze. And this petabyte per month, you can see how much it's growing year by year. And then all of you, I'm sure all of you know very well, that only the AI algorithms can extract from this data the gold, the specialized data, the all the connected data with the market. Because all of you know that extracting statistics according to what the customer are looking for, which is the trend in the market, you can see only analyzing the data with the data mining, and then have the predictive information through the algorithmics. All of you already know, all of you in this field already know how much useful is the algorithms like Google developer TensorFlow, other things for this kind of data extracting. So and all the algorithms give to the factory, to the brand, the possibility to predict the market. Predict the market is a big word, because you know, if you predict the market, you already prepare everything, you already save the cost of the wastage, you already save the energy, you already save many costs, and not only, you already read in the market, and the market, when you arrive there, the market accepts you soon. So you are successful in the market for this reason. So this data give you more than the gold, because you can use for predict many parts. You can use predict the production line, for organized metal production line, for don't have a warehouse, because already the market, you know what needs, already delivered to the sell point, the right product that the customer will buy, or even you already can deliver directly to the customer, because you have all the customer data, and not only, you have all the customer information. You know if the customer in any kind of field. You know better than me. I can talk 1 month here about all the field the AI is useful for. So by data, by smartphone, and through our data, now we don't have only the orders to the e-commerce platform, but we every day we use in China WeChat, QQ, like social, we have become the new Agora, where people exchange idea through the emotion. So in Europe, we have Facebook, we have WhatsApp or something like that, similar, where the people every day writing the emotion, write the idea, write what they like. All this data, you can even know everything about a relationship, about concerning the psychology of the population. So the big data, the data they can collect, is not only become analyzed by the market for sell product. Also, you know the mood, you know the political way, you know many information about all your population. So China for and any kind of a country no want this data for improve the social life, for support the people in the healthy, for support the people to satisfy them with the government services. You know, all the country invest money for support of the population, the old people living, the new generation, for develop them, for let them find a job, and for take care the old people in the hospital in the day life. So this data also are used for know which is the best way for support them in the psychology, support them in services, support them in find a new job, and which is the trend of the market. So we can support even a university and the training center for training the people according to the trend of the market. So everything will be optimized in using data. Now we are going to see the industrial robots market in China, where you can see this one will exceed $4 billion on 2017. China, after the revolution of the industry start 4.0, they start to change from the manual worker to the robots and to automatic production line. Because they got the same problem Europe got many years ago. The new graduate guy, they don't like to go to work in the factory. They are raised by the family, so they like to work in office. And then the factory become lake of workers. Lake of workers means the automation is the only way for support the production, the factory to still successful in the market. And here in this report belong to China Daily, we can see that how many it is estimated that more 110,000 industrial robots will be sold in China in 2017. And in the meantime, China's service robot market will reach $1.3 billion this year, up 28% per year. So, and not only, you can see in the other news where nearly 300 artificial intelligence specialist representative will join the conference on August 2017 for the World Robot Conference. So that means many engineers, many researchers, many professors in full the world, for all world, they come to China because they already understood how much China invests in this kind of field. Tencent is the father of QQ, WeChat, and other many kind of platform here. Was one of the first competitor of Skype many years ago. He got a lot of big technology and many customers, because all of the Chinese are using WeChat for as a social platform, for chat, for daily life, for the payment, for many things. And Tencent invests a lot in AI because he has a lot of big data in the cloud. So Tencent, the company behind China's biggest chat platform, WeChat, will open a robotics lab in Shenzhen, upgrading the company's research effort in AI area. They say, why robot? Tencent is researching different AI algorithms for Go playing program, fine art, and AI software control system. Interacting with a real object is also an opportunity to develop AI research on vision and language. Not only, as we said, the robots before, the Federal Reserve raising labor market price stimulated to research on robots that can substitute metal factory workers in labor-intensive company in Shenzhen. And then, therefore, the location of the labs is in Shenzhen because the Tencent head office is here. But in Shenzhen, there are thousands of high-tech companies that needed the skill of the workers. So when the labor become lack of the workers, the machine need to support the production. Also rising the power. Tencent already has two artificial intelligence research labs and a publisher of research paper. China's other two tech giants like Alibaba and Baidu. Alibaba is the biggest platform, I think all of you already have know before, for company, for look for product in China. And Baidu is the alter ego of the Google in China. And all of them investing in AI research because, as you know, all of them have a kind of a big data. And as we said before, in the cloud. We can see also another case, iFlytek company is another AI company in China. Don't let be cheated by the name. It's nothing concerned by drone or something concerning aerospace. This one is an artificial intelligence company with both innovative technology and prioritized to Chinese state security. They have developed the technology for the face recognition, the voice recognition, and the eyes. And as I said, its technology can monitor a car full of people or a crowded room, identify a target individual voice, and record everything that the person say. So they can support the China security every day in every place. Another case is belong to Lenovo spin-off. Lenovo, all of you know this kind of computer brand, and they develop the high tech, but not only for push the sale or for get some new idea also possible, but they invest in this kind of technology, they support this kind of for healthcare sector. Lenovo spin-off joins Chinese hospital to improve cancer survival rates with help on AI. So this technology going to support everybody, all the people in China are supporting by this kind of technology where the Lenovo invests on that. And we are going to see other cases. This other case is one new startup, Chinese AI startup, but only for show you a simple startup, but with a good idea. And in this kind of field, they got 220 million yuan and to be funded for global expansion. 220 million yuan, we can say, is around 30 million US dollar for one startup for the good technology, for the good idea. So that one can let you understand in which way one startup with a good idea, with a good project, can be funded in easy way and fast way. And we can see here from this slide another cases in China as who are the most developed AI startup in China. Yes, they said it's Chinese, but why is it Chinese? So for the same reason I said before. SenseTime is AI powered facial recognition company is breaking Fundo records. The news belong to Bloomberg say the SenseTime has released 600 million from Alibaba for this project and other investors at the valuation of over $3 billion, making it world's most valuable AI startup. And the spy money SenseTime technology help power Chinese massive surveillance network. The firm will use some of the cash to build at least 5 supercomputers for help track many thousands of live video feeds, boost staffing and fund push into autonomous driving and augmented reality. This kind of field are quite big funded and they have many implementation of the day life. And we can see other here firms already in talk and raise more cash is targeting to valuating over 4.5 billion. And since time AI Smart has been hiring loads, many AI doctors and researchers, and since 2015 has published more paper at the top AI conference than American giant such as Facebook and Google. So we don't want to compare in this moment as here China and the USA, because all of them, all of us need to give the contribution to innovation technology, to innovating product, to innovation innovative technology for support our daily life and support the future life. So I'm going now to summarize the possibility of the European small medium enterprise in AI industry in Europe to invest in China. The European companies can, as you said before, you saw before in my slides, open in China incubator for spin-off in artificial intelligence and robotics field, and use the European and binational Chamber of Commerce the support to promote artificial intelligence related projects and the most important conferences and show attended by Chinese government authorities worldwide company, because this connection must be used by you for go inside the country from the main door, where you can have the good advertising, you can have the good connection, and where from soon they can know you and your technology and what you are able to support. Use the high-tech working group, because each Chamber of Commerce has their own high-tech working group where you can transfer the new technology to all the members. So you are being supported by this kind of group already in China. This group are made by experts a long time in China, like me, like other colleagues, and relation in the high-tech field to support the young entrepreneurs to make their project successful in China market. And get the Chinese investor support through fund, advertising, connection to be successful in China and outside. Because when you show your project, you show your engineer, you show your knowledge here in the conference, in front of government people, in front of the funder, that one is easy to be funded and be supported to develop your technology even more. Now we arrive at the end and we go to see the conclusion. The conclusion of this webinar can be only this one. I'm reading for you, I'm talking with you, but you already can understand yourself that China is a huge market filled with many opportunities. China investors are fast and aggressive in the market. China government ought to be leader in an AI field by 2030. The government fund are ready to support all the AI new projects in China, and not only the government fund, but most of the local fund belong to the joint venture company, to the angel support for you, for the fund who want to invest in new technology. European and binational Chamber of Commerce can support to promote new technological projects here in China. So now it's easy to say, what is missing now? We miss only you. Your company can support us. Come here with your technology, with your invention, with your skilled engineer, for develop more fast your project, for support us to teach to some young engineer how to develop a new project, and then all together develop advanced project for China and for our own country. So in this way, joint the effort for both sides, joint the technology and joint the engineer, will be successful in the technology and support our future.
I hope this webinar was useful for all of you, and I hope to see you soon here in China together with all the other engineers for all the other countries. So have a good day and see you on the next webinar. See you.
This is the end of our presentation today. Thank you very much for your participation. I would like to remind you that there are still more webinars to come in the near future, so stay tuned. We look forward to seeing you again. Thank you again for watching and have a nice day.
Yeah.